the lot of the mind. Anekkiru kaalam vannal peenakkiru kaalam varum sudhalaya. Adu maari the mind also has got the same problem. What is that? Drishyah dhivrittayah. Dhivrittayah means manovrittayah, manasavrittayah. Minnala yadai manasam shunnalo adeda ipo dhi shulda. So dhivrittayah means mental function. Vidyaranya will explain later kama, krodha, lobha, moha, all of them. So all these mental functions are mind along with function. Apriya vichigurame. Mind along with its functions, drishyaha, they themselves become an object. So the very mind which was the subject from the standpoint of the eye means, very careful, chakshuhu lochanam, that very same mind becomes object with respect to what? Sakshi druk. So if the mind is the object, then what is the subject, the perceiver of the mind? Sakshi druk. Sakshi means the witness consciousness. Witness consciousness awareness is called sakshi. Sakshat nirvikarena ikshate. Karana nirapekshena, sakshat nirvikarena karana nirapekshena ikshate iti sakshi. So with respect to the mind, the awareness has become the subject perceiver. Sakshi has become the, awareness is called the sakshi. So now we have to see three statements. Rupam drishyam lochanam drik. Lochanam drishyam manasam drik. Manasam drishyam sakshi drik. So on ultimate analysis we find rupam also is drishyam. Lochanam also is drishyam. Manasam also is drishyam. And what is drik? Sakshi is drik. Okay. Since we have found every drik becoming drishyam later, lochanam drikka irundhathu apparam drishyama maariyirchu, manasam was drik, later became drishyam, then sakshi has become drik. Appa enna nenachupom? Sakshi drishyam sulugam tat pravaha patitatva. So Vidyaranya says you have to stop somewhere. Put point there in the where and apple hide there. So you cannot go on like this. Somewhere you have to stop. And therefore sakshi drik drik eva. Appa rendu sentence apichikanam. Sakshi drik full stop. Adukapra innoru sentence sakshi drik eva. So the witness consciousness is ever the perceiver, ever the awareer, ever the knower, ever the subject. Sakshi drigeva. Evakarartah kaha na drishyate. Ever perceiver means never perceived. Ever perceiver, never perceived. Ever drik, never drishyam. Sada drik, ahamasmi sada bhami. And therefore, what is drik and what is drishyam? External world of object is drishyam. Lochanam, the sense organs are also drishyam. Manasam, the mind also is drishyam. The awareness alone is drik. And therefore we can conclude the first three are jadam, the fourth one is alone chetanam. So rupam achetanam, lochanam achetanam, manasam achetanam, sakshi achetanam kundudalengo, sakshi chetanaha. Then you will have umpteen questions. Remember, this is Sangraha Shloka. All possible, plausible questions will be taken up, analyzed. This is for threadbare analysis. And therefore, Vidyaranya's view is, if by the word I, if you take the sakshi druk alone, aham brahmasmi will be smoothly understood. If in the word aham you include all the drishyams, drishyams na enalamuni, rupam, lochanam, manasam. Rupam, lochanam, manasam. Rupam represents shabdas parisha rupa rasaganda, the external world. So rupam na undu kadayadu, adha upalakshanam. Rupam stands for shabdasparisa rupa rasagandaha sarve vishayaha drishyaha. That should not be mixed with I vidrik sakshi. Similarly, lochanam stands for not only eyes but includes all the other sense organs also. Shrotram tvak chakshuhu rasana granam. So all the sense organs are drishyam, jadam. So therefore never have an alliance. Even if you cannot rule, never have an alliance. Election season, I'm the example over there. Never have an alliance with an unholy party. So lochanam is not a good one. And manasam also comes under drishyam, therefore never join. Work always independently better. Therefore aham drik brahma asmi, no complication. Whereas, what is the present condition? Na chollalenge, but I am just for your clarification, I am telling, when we use the word I now, we have ulithuvari potukade solranga, we have included a lot more stuff along with us. And we are trying to find out aham brahmasmi yappadi. chumma sonna porma. Isn't it true? Suppose I ask you a question, can you come? I am going to Rishikesh. Suppose. And I ask you, can you come 15 days? No, I am asking only the question, can you come? Now what all thoughts goes in your mind? Whether wife can come or not. Whether children can come or not. The dog enna pandra avan irukku. So what can be done with the dog? And what about the house? Remember, if there is problem in any one of them, drishyama drukka, suddenly, all are drishyavastu. You know, when you think whether I can come or not, the thought of I includes a lot more things, including office, obviously, enna pandrathu, leave kedaiyadhu. If I am the employer, I cannot leave. If I am the employee, leave kade. Endu vidhamum problem. So that makes it very clear that whenever I think about myself and my capacity and incapacity, I am taking into account the wife's capacity, incapacity, children's capacity, incapacity, office's capacity, incapacity, all of them. The I is the all-sweeping I. Adashchordvam prasrutas tasya shakah. Bangalore, Madras, Calcutta, California. Inge namurukhi. Anna totally all-pervasive in the parvala. California dan New York ada ya deh. Ika punya ini juga. San Francisco earthquake, who will worry? Whoever has got somebody's relatives, relative, north, fourth grade berunda, kuda worry dah. Anyway, leave it, you know enough of that. Therefore, aham includes the external drishyam. And of course, aham includes the sense organs with the body. And that is why you say, I come, I go, etc. And of course, the I includes the mind. Then you say, I am happy, I am unhappy, I am agitated, I am dull. Thus, I include the body sense organ, I include the external world, I include the mind also, and including them, I can never say aham brahmasmi. And once you do viveka and idam shariram kaunteya kshetramitya bhidiyate kshetratle moonu vandulu. Idam shariram kaunteya kshetramitya bhidhiyate, because mahabhuta nyahankaraha illate bhututa. We will see them in the 13th chapter on Sunday class. So then, having segregated kshetrajnaha the sakshi, kshetrajnam chapi imam vidhi. After separating the drishyam, Druk can happily say aham brahmasmi. And therefore this viveka is important. Thus he has summarized. Now each term in this shloka is going to be elaborated. What is the first term? Rupam drishyam lochanam druk. That will be elaborated in the second shloka. Tadrishyam driptu manasam will be elaborated in the third shloka. Then drishyadi vrittaya sakshi will be elaborated in the fourth shloka. Brigeva natu drishyate in the 5th sloka. Alaha, each quarter is explained in one sloka. Thus up to the 5th sloka, 2, 3, 4, 5 is a commentary upon the 1st sloka, 4 quarters. We will read the 2nd sloka. Nilapita sthula sukshma Hraswa dirghadi bhedataha Nana vidhani rupani Pashyen lochaname kadha This is a better tune. I have changed it from the first tune. Okay. So now, Rupam Drishyam Lochanam Drik. I'll explain Bandra. Rupam is Jatyeka Vachanam. Rupam Nainala Neela Peeta Sthula Sukshma, Hraswa, Dirgha, Adi Pedata. So the Rupam includes Neelam. Neelam, you know. Neelam means blue or dark. Black also is called Neelam. Neela Megha Shyamalaha Ngrade. Have you ever seen a blue cloud? So Neela Megha Ngrade. Neelam means dark. Then Peetam means yellow. Sthulam means big. Here Sthulam refers to Akaraha. Sthulam means big. Sukshman means small. Hraswam means short. Dirgham means long. Adi, etc. You can add any number more. Adi Bhedataha. In these varieties, Tritiyarthe Tasihi Itham Bhute Tritiya. In these various varieties, Nana Vidhani Rupani. The Rupams are many. So Nana, many. Vidha means varied. Nana in the simple numerical plural. Vidham indicates the variety also. Because plurality can be the same. Not only they are many, each one of them is different from another. As we say in English, many and varied. Nana Vidhani. Rupani. The Rupams are many and varied, whereas the Lochanam, the eye, is what na? Ekadha pashyet. It is one and without variation. Ekadha means eka prakaram. Vidhatik opposite, eka vidham nartam. So the idea is what? The objects are plural in number, but the eye is singular. It's going to kind of get along. Eye as an instrument. Or kind of moodle paathana abdiya da irukum. So therefore, eye is singular. Even though what it perceives is plural. Therefore, drishyam is nana, drik is ekam. That is one point. And the second point is drishyam varies, now yellow, now blue. Then what happens to the eye? When the yellow is seen, eye is yellow. When the blue is seen, eye is blue. When the big is seen, eye becomes pollak. So therefore, it's a very kandu varma. Chinnada pakarte kandu chinnadahumu unno. So when the objects are vividhani, eye is ekadhana ekavidham nartam. Anga nana vidham, inga ekavidham. Here it is one and unvaried. This is very important because the importance of this you will understand only when we come to Sakshi. Then only Advaitam of the Sakshi will be established and Kutasthatvam, Nirvikaratvam of the Sakshi will be established. Therefore, that point you have to remember. Lochanam ekadha pasye. So the first quarter has been commented. Now we have to go to the second quarter commentary in the third shloka, which we will see in the next class. Hari Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamivavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.